Let's talk a little bit about the different varieties of apples and their different habits of growth. And I'm doing this and this intentionally. Knowledgeable ones talk about two general habits of growth of fruit trees: acratonic, upright, and bassetonic, broad. Acratonic, like an acrobat, has no fear of heights. If you're acrophobic, you do have fear of heights. Acratonic trees tend to have a genetic makeup that makes them grow more upright than not. Bassetonic trees, just the opposite. They're low and wide. So on my right here is the aforementioned Mutsu, which along with Fuji and Gravenstein are some of the most vigorous apples I know of. That's just their inherent genetic vigor. And on my left here is a really nice prize old heirloom from 1700s from Newtown, Long Island. It's called Yellow Newtown Pippin. And it's been made famous by the Pajaro Valley in Central California. They grow, or formerly have grown, a whole lot of it. Good fresh-eaten apple, good storage apple, good pie apple, excellent sweet cider apple. What are the growth characteristics of Yellow Newtown Pippin? It tends to be more acratonic and upright. The Mutsu is a little bit of a tweener. It is both upright but also spreading or bassetonic. The Yellow Newtown Pippin is a really tidy, nice tree, easy to manage. It just behaves well in an open center form like that. It's less inherently less vigorous than the Mutsu. And that's not anything about what you did or didn't do to the tree in terms of soil and fertility. That's its genetic nature, a little less vigorous. Moderate, and it's not weak. You still have the same spacing in the row here, about 12 feet. You could have gone a couple, 3 feet closer, got a little higher tree density, got a little higher yield per row here. But Yellow Newtown Pippin, a well-behaved tree is what I would say. Here we have the Holstein apple. Let's look at it in a couple respects. Let's look at the variety itself. It's a Cox's Orange Pippin derivative. Unlike Cox, it's a pretty big apple. Much like Cox, it's extremely aromatic and intensely flavorful. Real good amount of sugar, balancing acidity. Sometimes if you get it dead right off the tree, got a little hazelnut in there. It's exquisite. Holstein. It is a pretty weak variety that is somewhat bassetonic. Easy to manage in that regard, and is like most Cox's Orange Pippin's derivatives or offspring, an annual regular bearer. Sets a good crop almost without fail, even under adverse weather conditions, every year. And this is something to be prized in apples. One, apples, by their very nature, even with the best of care, and part of that means thinning and thinning in a timely manner, tend to be a bit alternate bearing. You'll have a heavy year and a moderate or light year. If you don't get in there and thin in a timely manner, you'll have a heavy year and a really shy year. But the Cox's types generally are going to set a moderate to heavy crop every year and can do so even under adverse bloom time weather conditions.